Fox from the Barefoot Wine and Bubbly joins us again, and this time we're pairing wine with food. Good morning.
Good morning. It's good to be here again.
Yes, and for the holidays, this is obviously a big thing. People may be having parties, and they really want to show their guests up.
Exactly. So food and wine pairings is a really easy thing too. And with Barefoot Wine, we have so many different options that it's really easy. We have wines to go with almost any food that you'd like. We have over 14 different types in our portfolio. They're all fun, flavorful, and best of all, they're under around $7, so they're very affordable.
Oh, and that makes it easy to buy multiple types, so you kind of have a variety at the party.
Exactly. So you can have something to go with your appetizer, with your main course, and then something else with your dessert. So one thing also is that if you have a little bit of Merlot left over from the night before, you definitely don't want to waste it, and what you can do is you can make some Barefoot dark chocolate Merlot brownies.
Wow, brownie with wine in it. That sounds amazing. You have just made the perfect brownie.
So really, and I'm not a whiz in the kitchen, so if I can make them, anybody can make them. So what you're going to do is take, I've got the ingredients here. I've got some dark chocolate and butter, and mix that in a saucepan, and then you're going to slowly add each of the ingredients. A little bit of Merlot, some vanilla, eggs, sugar, flour, and cocoa powder. Just mix that up in the saucepan. So it's only one pot, which makes it really easy. And then you take a foil-lined pan, and you pour the batter right directly into the pan, and then stick it in the oven for at 350 degrees for about 25 minutes.
Wow, I'm interested. Yeah. I want to try.
Absolutely.
I want to see how strong the wine is.
Right? So the wine is going to actually cook out a little bit, so there's not going to be really a lot of alcohol flavor in it. So while it's all cooking, then what you do is you take some milk chocolate, some more butter, and a little bit more Merlot, and mix that in another saucepan to make the glaze on top so they look really, really tasty.
See, you know, that is good. Just a fair hint of that red wine. And perfect use. I hate wasting wine, but sometimes you just can't drink it up the next day.
Right. And these pair really well with a glass of Merlot, so you can even open another bottle if necessary, and sit right by the fire with your glass of wine.
Okay, so which types of flavors are you thinking for the holiday?
So these are all some are great pairings. What you can do is you can mix some Pinot Noir, or pair Pinot Noir with a roast garlic pork roast.
Okay, can do savory.
Exactly. So you do some Shiraz with some fire-roasted chili. Chardonnay, I love to make that with macaroni and cheese.
Interesting. And then classic. Make it a little bit more
classic. Exactly, a little bit more adult. And then you can do for dessert, you can do some chocolate mousse with Cabernet Sauvignon. And then you can do a fruit plate with our extra sweet Moscato, which is really nice.
Interesting.
Light, sweet, fruity. And of course, all of these pair really well with the cheese plate as well.
Yes, always goes well with that.
Always.
And I notice here on the label, it actually says what they go well with. So that's kind of helpful. When you're in the store, you can kind of get an idea.
Exactly. Look at the back of the label. It's something really easy. Something else you can always remember is that white wine is really well with white meat or light meat, and darker wines like red wines are better with darker meats.
That's easy to remember.
Exactly.
Light with light, dark with dark.
Exactly.
Okay,
but at the end of the day, you pair it with what you like.
That's, end of the day, you just drink what you want.
Exactly.
And what do we have here?
So this is some of our extra dry that we had from last time, so I thought we could just cheers.
Cheers.
Happy
New Year, everyone. Back to you, Jen.